Thank you for the introduction and for the invitation. Hello, my name is Asa Dotzler. I'm a Mozillian. I've been with Mozilla for about 15 years now. My business card says storyteller and spokesmodel, but my real work at Mozilla has been mostly non-technical and mostly focused on lowering barriers to participation in Mozilla projects. I'm sure most of you know, but there may be a few who don't, so I'll tell you a little bit about Mozilla. Mozilla is a nonprofit organization. Our shareholders are the people of planet Earth, the several billion people who are already developing, participating in, and consuming web experiences, and the 5 or 6 billion more that will come online over the next decade or so. We do a lot of things at Mozilla, but we're most well known for the Firefox web browser and more recently for a mobile operating system called Firefox OS. Like everything we do, Firefox and Firefox OS are open source software. In addition to being licensed open source, they're also open projects. We focus a lot of attention on making sure that our projects are approachable and participatory, from the initial planning stages through development and support, from the top of the stack to the bottom of the stack. Everything we do is meant to be open, approachable, accessible, and participatory. That means that I don't have any secrets to reveal here today, any new product announcements or anything like that. And virtually everything I say you can find behind one of these three links. I hope that that doesn't disappoint, and I hope that the talk is still valuable for a whole bunch of you. In the next 10 or 15 minutes, I'm going to share with you the work we've done to bring WebRTC to our browsers over the last couple of years, our ongoing work to put WebRTC into the Firefox OS mobile operating system, and I'm going to give you a brief introduction to an application we're building into Firefox, the browser, and Firefox OS, currently codenamed Loop, that will give consumers, give users of the product, a chat experience. I don't need to go into the full history of WebRTC because you all got a great briefing in the earlier first couple of sessions, but 1 year ago this week, Mozilla shipped Firefox version 22 on the desktop to Mac, Windows, and Linux with the full WebRTC stack, that is, get user media, peer connection, and data channel. Two releases after that, about 3 months later, we added the full stack to our Android browser so that we had Gecko is Gecko is Gecko, our web runtime inside of our desktop browser, Mac, Windows, and Linux, and our Android mobile browser all run the same software, virtually the same software, and you should get the same experiences out of them. We started on the desktop for a couple of reasons. A lot of people ask why we didn't start on mobile first, where everyone else is. The first reason is the desktop had the horsepower. A couple of years ago, mobile wasn't where it is today. The processing power made a big difference. Connectivity of Wi-Fi versus less solid connectivity on mobile devices, as well as the fact that Google was starting its implementation on the desktop and pushing mobile till later as well. And so we worked with Google and the Chrome team quite a bit to develop the WebRTC standards and to design and build an interoperable WebRTC implementation between the Chrome browsers and the Firefox browsers. I think this is really important as we demonstrate that the web is about multi-vendor solutions. And the fact that we could produce WebRTC video chats from the Chrome browser to the Firefox browser over a year ago is, I think, proof that WebRTC is on its way to becoming a fundamental component of the web. After the desktop and the mobile work, we moved on to integrating WebRTC into Firefox OS. How many people here are familiar with our mobile operating system? And how many people are familiar with the architecture of our mobile operating system? So I'll start there real quick. Firefox OS is an open source mobile operating system. And what we've done here is we've taken the Linux kernel and HAL and other drivers down at the various low level. We package that up into a module we call Gonk. I call it Gonk. It's all the ugly stuff I don't like to think about. But above that, we drop Gecko onto it, right on top. There's no in-between layer. We drop our web runtime right on top of the kernel and drivers. And above that, we've built, using web languages, all pure HTML, JavaScript, CSS, the things you know and love, a series of system components and applications that ship on Firefox OS mobile phones. This includes things like our start screen, a dialer, you need a dialer on a phone, address book, camera interfaces, all of these kinds of things. Firefox OS is a web-native platform. I hear a lot of people talk about the native stacks out there and the web versus the native stacks. I'm just old enough to remember when Java wasn't really considered a native stack. It was a plugin to the browsers or a server-side technology. And with Firefox OS, what we're trying to do is assert that JavaScript, HTML, CSS, and friends are the native platform. They are as close to the metal as we can get them, as highly tuned and performant as we can get them. And the purpose of building this new architecture and this new product is because we think the web is the greatest platform ever invented, and that the next 4, 5, 6 billion people who come online are going to be coming online and experiencing that through mobile devices first. And we want the web to be a first-class citizen on those mobile devices. Mozilla employees, our global community of tens of thousands of volunteers, and a bunch of Firefox OS ecosystem partners. These are the people who are building the handsets, the carriers and operators, our retail partners, all work together in the open to build Firefox OS. One of the unique aspects of this development is that any of you can be involved as well. We don't batch up a whole bunch of changes and toss them over the wall every 3 or 6 months. Everything we do, like I said, from design to implementation, from the top to the bottom of the stack, is open and participatory from day one. But mobile and the web have had a tricky relationship over the last 4 or 5 years. And one of the major reasons for that is that mobile browsers are what we think of when we think of mobile on the web. And the mobile browsers have typically been fairly crippled. If you look at the browsers on iOS over the last few years, you didn't get any of the really nice jitter JavaScript performance out of it. I think Apple's rectifying that. Google's also bringing some of that really nice performance to upcoming versions of Android. But with Firefox OS, where we don't have to think about it in terms of a browser, and we can actually deliver the full capability of the web platform without any of the legacy of what you need to put onto something to make it a browser, we were able to achieve some pretty significant performance wins. And on top of that, we started closing the gap between the actual device capabilities available to you in the native stacks and those available to you in the web stack. And we did this through a project called Web API. Web API is everything we know and love from the last 20 years of web development, from HTML and JavaScript and CSS. But it's also a new class of APIs that will fill those gaps, the pieces of hardware, the sensors, and the services and other capabilities that we find on mobile devices that we don't typically find on desktops and laptops, should all be accessible through APIs that are comfortable, familiar, and accessible to web developers. And that's what we're building into Firefox OS today. And we've got 30 or 40 of these going. All of them are intended to be standardized, ultimately. And a few of them are available in the desktop browser to try out. A few of them are available in our mobile browser. But the real focus of the Web API development effort is in Firefox OS, which is available for download and testing, just as the Firefox browser is. So where are we with Firefox OS and WebRTC? We shipped our first version of Firefox OS about a year ago. It was a year and a half ago that we declared version 1.0 done, but it was about a year before our partners were able to get those devices into market. That went into about 15 markets. That is up to about 35 today, and by the end of this year, I think we're closer to 40 markets. I'll have to double check on that. We'll be up to 30 geographies by the end of this year. We shipped Firefox OS version 1.3 at the beginning of this year. It's the current in-market newest release, and all of our team are hard at work on Firefox 2.0 and 2.1. 2.0 is where we introduce WebRTC. We've had some pieces. I think we had Get User Media there for a little while, but Firefox OS version 2.0, which is wrapping up in the next couple of months and hitting devices in-market by the end of this year, maybe mid-fourth quarter, will have Get User Media, Peer Connection, and Data Channel, and an implementation that should be highly compatible, given that this is the Gecko stack, with our Mac, Windows, Linux, and Android browser views. And that should make it really easy for you to take the work you've done on WebRTC apps and to deploy those to any of the Firefox or Chrome browsers out there, as well as, with only hopefully minor changes, packaging them up, and shipping them as Firefox OS apps. In addition, you can also load up the browser inside of Firefox OS and treat it just as a regular web-based app. We've still got a lot of bugs to iron out, and we're especially focused on performance optimizations as you move to mobile and as you move into the Firefox OS mobile space, which is targeting the mid-tier and low end of the market and not the hero phones with, you know, 8-core processors and running at, you know, 2.5 gigahertz, but more like these $100 and $150 devices that have a dual-core processor and you know, 512 megs of RAM. So getting into those spaces with performance is our big challenge and where most of our effort is right now. But we think we've made some really good progress, and we'd love for you all to check that out. Once again, we're working very hard to make sure that Gecko is Gecko is Gecko, whether you're hitting on a desktop browser, a mobile browser, or Firefox OS. When you develop a WebRTC application or solution for our platform, it should work on all of these form factors. I'm going to wrap with a little bit of information on a project that's pretty new to Mozilla, and this is to take a bunch of the work we've done in WebRTC, which empowers you all and our developer community to build great experiences, and surface some of that to our users of the Firefox browser and of the Firefox OS mobile operating system. We want to build an actual app, a user experience that will let people very quickly and easily chat between them and their friends on their browsers and in an app on the mobile operating system. Right now, Loop is very early in development. It's meant to be quick and easy. We're not trying to, I don't believe we're trying to take on any of the highly successful commercial video chat applications out there. We want to make it super simple. And so the first implementation looks kind of like this. You'll open up your Firefox web browser, you'll click on a little chat icon, and it will give you a URL to yourself. You give that to your friend clicks on it, you get a little pop-up, accept call from friends, say yes, and you get a video pop-up window that floats in your browser on top of the tab you're currently viewing. You can pop that out into a freestanding window, you can go full screen, you can navigate all your other browser tabs and move between windows, and the call continues and stays functional, and that allows you to surf around the web while you're talking to one of your friends. That's an anonymous experience. We're also working to integrate with Firefox accounts, and that will allow you to communicate to people via their Firefox account email addresses. It will also give you the opportunity to store an address book, import, edit, and store address book information to set who can and cannot call you. Maybe we'll have like auto answer or block answers for certain people that are calling you too often. And then all of this will be similarly packaged up and deployed as an application that users can download, install, and run on Firefox OS devices. So it is basic and it is anonymous today. We're growing out the further functionality. I think you can get a look at this today. There's a URL up here that will give you all of the architectural information about Loop as well as some of the design documentation. And I think it's in nightly builds of Firefox. So any of you who are on the very tip of our development there can get a good look at it through the Firefox web browser nightly channel. And as I come to the conclusion here, I want to wrap with something that one of my good friends, Mary Reavy, our media goddess at Mozilla and one of the core members of the WebRTC team, please help us bring real-time communications to the web. We're not done yet. We need your help to build great applications and experiences. We need your help in feedback as we develop the APIs and work toward a next version and additional capabilities. We need you to report bugs on our implementations and our competitors' implementations, and to seek out interoperability and call us out when we don't have it. We need you to help us test and develop. With your help and your ideas and your enthusiasm, we're going to take the web to a whole new level. Thank you.